sayang. Tonight, in front of our close friends and family, I promise to spend the rest of my life loving, respecting and honoring you. It's quite a big promise to make, but one that I will keep. I will keep this promise because I want to spend the rest of my life with you. When you are feeling weak, I will be strong. When you are upset, my shoulder will always be there for you. And when you are under the weather, I will be the sunshine. You can't fully understand how you make me feel. With you, I can be me. I feel love unconditionally and that makes me feel free. I feel that you have found something in me that you love and it doesn't matter if I'm having a bad day or if I'm looking less than my best. You still see it and you love me because of it. I love you. I love every part of you. You always find time to make me feel special and to ensure that I'm happy. Sayang, you have a determination. If you want something, you find a way to get it and work hard to achieve it. Because of this, I know that you will be successful and reach your goals one day, inshallah. I look forward to spending the rest of my life with you. I hope that you will believe in me as much as I believe in you and in us.
First time jumpa Idrina, end of 2014. That time
I was doing my masters and then that it was Christmas break. So I cakap kat my cousin that I'm going to their place to stay for a few days. Happened to be Azim was there but I tak jumpa dia.
Actually whenever I come down to London, rumah cousin dia tu jadi macam rumah tumpangan.
There's only one room. So I macam oh, that room was is taken. So I macam okay, tak apa. I shall wait for that person lah because my cousin kata memang kawan dia dah tidur situ. But then I waited until like 2 AM. I macam alah, mamak ni pergi clubbing ke apa ke. So I macam okay lah, tak apalah. I selamba je tidur dalam bilik tu. I dengan harapan macam pandai lah dia kan. So the next day I woke up with my niece. Dia dah dekat rumah lah. And he had to sleep on the couch sebab I dah ambil bilik tu.
So 30 Disember tu ada plan to do something for New Year, tengok fireworks and everything. From encouragement from a friend, tanya Idrina kalau dia ada plan ke on 31 Disember tu.
Dia tanya I, oh what is your plan for New Year? So I cakap nak tengok fireworks. So I tanya I, you want to join? So I cakap maybe boleh kot.
Then we managed to arrange dinner.
Because it was my birthday juga, so he belanja dinner. And then we went to watch fireworks dengan some friends.
After we met January 15, we met few more times in UK. In April, I think, I bawa dia pergi tengok football match. Manchester United versus Aston Villa rasanya. I also know that dia pun support Manchester United. So after the match, I officially asked her if she wants to be my girlfriend. Lepas Idrina habis masters, that was September 2015. So we had to manage a long distance relationship.
I thought I couldn't go through long distance sebab I've never believed in long distance. I think because I bangun tidur nak pergi kerja, dia baru nak tidur. Which sometimes dia dah penat kerja, I macam fresh. So kita orang punya conversation is like okay lah, just sekejap je because dah different mindset kan masa tu.
The thought of give up tu akan sentiasa ada. I think more uncertainty rasanya. We all pun tak tahu actually apa plan seterusnya. Sebab Idrina dah balik KL. Throughout 2015 tu, I'm still in UK. Rasa dah balik KL tapi tak tahu opportunity keadaan kat KL. I've been in UK since 2003.
It all boils down to him lah. I think Azim wanted the relationship so much. So I macam, the relationship will not work kalau I nak, dia tak nak. So I want the relationship. So and he works to it. He is a nice guy and I cannot find another guy yang macam dia, yang macam I think he tick at least 95% of my boxes kot.
After few months we talk and discuss, the best point is for me to move to KL sebab in the end Malaysia tu home, and then it's easier transition for me if I go back to Malaysia rather than Idrina coming to UK. So we went to Singapore for holiday and to meet some friends. The proposal happened the night of 30 December after a nice dinner kat Singapore near the Marina Bay.
Muhammad Izzani. Saya nikahkan kamu dengan anak perempuanku, Dina binti Muhammad Khalil, dengan mas kahwinnya 2 dinar tunai.
Saya terima nikah Dina binti Muhammad Khalil dengan mas kahwin 2 dinar tunai.
Alhamdulillah.
I'll try to be the best wife ever. As you always say, I'm the best ever. So, I'll try to be your best companion in what else? I try to be less degil so that I can listen to you more. And I will love you forever.